I thank God for the opportunity to be here once again.
Zahvaljujem Bogu za priliku da mogu biti s vama opet ovo jutro.
I thank God for the leadership of the church.
Zahvaljujem Bogu za vodstvo ove crkve.
For giving me this privilege to speak to you again this morning.
Da su mi dali ovu privilegiju da mogu vama govoriti ovo jutro ponovo.
This morning I want to share with you briefly on what I titled from faith to faithfulness.
Ovo jutro htio bih nešto reći o te na temu od vjere do vjernosti.
And I want you to listen intensively.
I želim da pažljivo slušate.
I'm going to try to be slow when speaking so that she will be able to interpret me very well.
Pokušat ću biti spor i dobro izgovara riječi da naša prevoditeljica nema problema.
You have to forgive me sometimes when I run.
Morat ćeš mi, kaže, oprostiti ako malo prebrzo odem.
And you keep me in your prayers so that I won't run
off. A vi se molite za mene za to.
Amen. From faith to faithfulness.
Od vjere do vjernosti.
And the subject of faith is a very fundamental subject in the Bible.
I tema vjere je osnovna tema u Bibliji.
In fact, it's the cornerstone of all the teachings in the Bible.
U stvari, temelj je svih učenja u Bibliji.
And the book of Hebrews, chapter number 11, verse 6 says, "For without faith, it is impossible to please God."
U stvari, u Hebrejima 11:6 kaže da bez vjere nemoguće mu je ugoditi.
For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and he is a rewarder of those who seek him.
Jer onaj koji dolazi Bogu treba vjerovati, treba znati da Bog nagrađuje one koji mu dolaze u vjeri.
But over the years, the subject of faith has been taught as a means for us to receive something from God.
Ali kroz u zadnje vrijeme, kroz zadnje godine, također tema vjere je upotrebljena kao nešto da dobijemo od Boga, sredstvo kako da dobijemo stvari od Boga.
Which is right.
I to je istina.
You have to have faith for healing.
Trebate imati vjeru za iscjeljenje.
Have faith for anything that you want to get from God.
Trebate imati vjeru za bilo što što želite od Boga.
So practically faith is the only currency that heaven recognizes.
Tako da vjera jeste jedina valuta koju nebo prepoznaje.
But so we come to God to receive.
Tako da mi dolazimo Bogu da bismo primili.
And many a times we have faith to receive from God.
I često imamo tu vjeru da primimo od Boga.
We have faith for our house, we have faith for the things we believe God for.
Imamo vjeru za našu kuću, za stvari za koje molimo od Boga.
But the Bible says God rewards the faithful.
Ali Biblija kaže da Bog nagrađuje vjerne.
God rewards the faithful.
Bog nagrađuje vjerne.
And so recently the Holy Spirit has been speaking to me that we need to move from faith, from just having faith to being faithful.
Tako da mi je Duh Sveti počeo govoriti da moramo se pomaknuti od mjesta vjere do mjesta vjernosti.
So that we don't just come to God to receive.
Tako da Bogu ne dolazimo samo da bismo primili.
So that we don't just have faith to receive things from God.
Tako da nemamo samo vjeru da bismo primili stvari od Boga.
God wants us to be faithful.
Bog želi da mi budemo vjerni.
So the Holy Spirit said to me that we need to move from being just having faith to being faithful.
Tako da Duh Sveti mi je govorio da moramo se pomaknuti od toga da imamo vjere do mjesta da smo vjerni.
So when the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me concerning this,
i kad mi je Duh Sveti to progovorio,
I have to find the word faithful from the first time it was mentioned in the Bible.
Tako da sam potražio prvi put gdje je riječ vjernost ili biti vjeran spomenuta u Bibliji.
In theology there is a principle that is called the law of first mention.
U Bibliji ima, u teologiji ima nešto što se zove prvog spomena, teologija prvog spomena.
Which says that if you really want to find a true meaning of the word in the Bible.
Tako da ako želite naći pronaći pravo značenje neke riječi u Bibliji.
You have to find the first time that word is being mentioned.
Morate naći mjesto gdje se prvi put pojavljuje ta riječ u Bibliji.
So I had to look up for the word faithful.
Tako da sam potražio riječ vjeran.
And the first time the word faithful is being mentioned is in the book of Numbers.
Prvi put gdje je spomenuta riječ vjeran, biti vjeran, jeste u knjizi Brojeva.
Numbers chapter 12.
Brojevi 12.
In Numbers chapter 12, you know, God says that, you know, there was a situation that arose.
U brojevima 12 Bog govori u situaciji koja je nastala.
It has to do with the church.
I ima veze sa crkvom.
Which Moses was the pastor.
Crkvom kojoj je pastor bio Mojsije.
And then the senior sister was also a minister in that church.
I njegova sestra je također bila službenik u toj crkvi.
Her name was Miriam.
I njeno ime bilo je Miriam.
And the senior brother was also a minister in the church.
I njegov brat također je bio u toj crkvi starješina.
And so the Bible says in the book of Numbers chapter 12.
Biblija kaže u knjizi Brojeva broj 12, poglavlje 12.
That the senior brother and the senior sister of Moses had a problem with Moses' wife.
I piše u znači poglavlju 12 da su Miriam i Aaron, njegov brat i sestra, imali problem sa Mojsijevom ženom.
And the reason is because Moses' wife was an Ethiopian.
I razlog je bio što je njegova žena bila iz Etiopije.
And so the Bible says that, you know, they couldn't come up straight and say to Moses, I don't like your wife.
I ta Biblija kaže da oni nisu samo mogli doći jednostavno Mojsiju i reći, slušaj, mi ti tvoju ženu ne volimo.
So they spiritualized the issue.
Tako da su malo produhovnili cijelu stvar.
And said to Moses, are you the only one that hears from God?
I onda mu došli i rekli, jesi li ti to jedini koji čuješ od Boga? Mi smo isto pomazani.
God is also using us.
Bog isto nas koristi.
We can also pray for the sick.
Mi isto tako možemo moliti za bolesne.
We can also hear from God.
Možemo isto čuti od Boga.
And so the Bible says God has to step into that situation.
Biblija kaže da je Bog mora ući u tu situaciju.
In Numbers chapter 12 verse 7.
I u brojevima 12:7
God step into the situation.
Bog ulazi u tu situaciju.
And that is the first instance the word faithful was mentioned.
I to je prvi put gdje se spominje riječ vjera.
So God says in Numbers chapter 12 verse 7, he said, my servant Moses is not so, who is faithful in all my house.
I kaže Bog u 12:7, ali nije tako sa slugom mojim Mojsijem, od svih u kući mojoj najvjerniji je on.
So when God came in to address this situation,
tako da kad je Bog ušao da riješi ovu situaciju,
that was contentious in this particular church,
koji je bio problem i koji je uzrok konflikta u
God
ovoj crkvi,
God was saying that I am not looking at your skills.
Bog je rekao, ja ne tražim vaše darove i vještine. Ne tražim nešto što možete učiniti.
That is not just about the anointing and what you can do.
I nije to samo u vezi vaše pomazanja
so
i šta
God
vi možete
says,
učiniti.
Moses, my servant, is faithful.
Nego Bog kaže, Mojsije moj sluga, najvjerniji je on.
Moses is faithful.
Mojsije je vjeran.
So that means that God desires faithfulness.
To znači da Bog traži vjernost.
It's not just about what you can do.
I nije samo u vezi toga što ti možeš učiniti.
Practically anyway.
Praktično svakako.
There is nobody that wants to deal with somebody that is unfaithful.
Niko ne želi svakako se nositi s nekim koji je nevjeran.
Not in relationship.
Ne u odnosima.
Not at the place of work.
Ne u poslovnom svijetu.
Everybody is looking for somebody that is faithful.
Svatko traži nekoga ko je vjeran.
Somebody that can stand firm.
Neko ko može stati čvrsto.
Somebody that you can be sure of. Somebody that you can be sure of.
Ne,
sure. Sure, certain.
A neko za koga možeš biti potpuno siguran.
So the word faithful.
Tako da riječ vjernost
means to stand firm.
Znači stajati čvrsto.
God is looking for those who will stand firm.
Bog traži one koji će stajati čvrsto.
To move from just having faith to receive things from God.
Tako da se, koji će se pomaknuti s mjesta da imaju vjeru samo da prime stvari od Boga.
To being faithful.
Do mjesta gdje će biti vjeran.
That's what God is looking for.
To je ono što Bog traži.
Praise the Lord.
Slava Bogu.
Praise the Lord.
Slava Bogu.
God is looking for the faithful.
Bog traži vjerne.
And God is calling us from just having faith to get things from Him.
Bog nas pomiče s mjesta da imamo vjeru samo da primamo stvari od njega.
To being faithful.
Da budemo vjerni.
When you talk about faithfulness.
Kada govorite o toj vjernosti.
You're talking about relationship.
Govorimo o odnosu.
God does not just want us to come to Him.
Bog ne želi samo da mi dođemo njemu.
And get things.
I da dobijemo stvari.
Receive healing.
Da primimo isciljenje, primimo
God wants to have
proboj.
Relationship with us.
Bog želi imati odnos s nama.
That is the primary thing that he created God created us for.
To je osnovni razlog zašto nas je stvorio.
That's why we were created in the image and likeness of God.
Zato smo I stvoreni na sliku Božju.
God wants to have relationship with us.
Bog želi imati odnos s nama.
Faithfulness is about relationship.
Vjernost je u vezi odnosa.
God wants to have a relationship with us.
Bog želi imati vjer
When you look at the Bible,
kada gledate kroz Bibliju,
in the Old Testament,
u Starom Zavjetu,
the Bible talks about a man Abraham.
Biblija govori o čovjeku koji se zove
and he
Abraham.
Said Abraham was the friend of God.
I kaže Abraham je bio prijatelj Božji.
He was a friend.
On je bio prijatelj.
So much that God will come to Abraham and discuss personal issues.
I toliko prijatelj da bi Bog došao Abrahamu I razgovarao o osobnim stvarima. I to je nivo odnosa koji Bog želi s nama.
When God wanted to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah,
kada je Bog htio da uništi Sodom
he
I Gomoru,
went to his friend
on je otišao svom prijatelju
and talked to Abraham
I pričao s njim.
And said, what about, what the, how do you see Sodom and Gomorrah?
I pitao šta ti misliš u vezi Sodom
and
I Gomorrah?
Abraham remembered he had a relation there.
I onda se Abraham sjetio da ima rođaka tamo.
He said, God, you can't just destroy that city.
I rekao Abraham, Bože, ne this možeš samo uništiti. To je odnos.
And God said, tell me why I can't destroy the city.
I Bog kaže, zašto misliš da ne mogu uništiti grad?
And Abraham said, what about if you find 50 righteous folks?
I onda Abraham kaže, šta ako nađeš 50 vjernih?
Will you still destroy the city?
Da li ćeš još uvijek uništiti grad?
And God said, well, you know,
I Bog kaže,
if I find 50,
pa, dobra,
if you said I can find 50,
nađem 50, neću.
You know, I will spare the city.
Ja ću poštediti grad.
And the Bible says an angel was sent.
I Biblija kaže da je anđeo poslan.
And there were no 50 folks.
I nije bilo ni 50.
And so God came back to Abraham.
I Bog se vratio Abrahamu.
And so you didn't succeed. There are no 50 folks in the
Evo,
city.
Potražili smo, pretražili grad,
so,
nema.
What do you say?
Nema 50, šta
this
kažeš?
This is relationship.
To je odnos.
God wants to have relationship with us.
Bog želi imati odnos s nama.
It's not just about coming to church.
Nije samo u vezi toga da dođeš I pojaviš se
It's
u crkvi.
It's about relationship with God.
To je u vezi odnosa s Bogom.
It's not just about church.
Nije u vezi crkve.
Each of us has to have that intimate personal relationship with God.
Abraham I mi treba da imamo takav jedan osobni odnos s Bogom.
And God said to
Bog
Abraham,
je rekao, Abraham.
How about 20 folks?
Šta kažeš na 20?
Abraham said, God, if you find 20, if you find 20 people, will you still destroy the city?
Abraham kaže Bog, ako nađeš 20 ljudi, da li ćeš onda uništiti grad?
The Bible says Abraham
Biblija kaže
was
Abraham
a friend of God.
Je bio prijatelj Božji.
A friend.
Prijatelj.
Of God.
Božji.
God wants to have a relationship with us.
Bog želi da ima odnos s nama.
And God cannot have a relationship with God, with us.
A Bog ne može imati odnos s nama.
If we are unfaithful.
Ako smo nevjerni.
If we just come to him.
Ako mu samo dolazimo.
You know, sometimes if you have a friend that only calls you on the phone when he's in need, will you think that
Na primjer, kad imate prijatelja koji vas samo zove kad mu treba nešto.
Hello, can I have some 200 kunas there?
Mogu li ima 200 kuna? E, izvini, treba mi.
And then you give the 200 kuna.
I onda mu daš 200 kuna.
And you never heard from this friend
I
again.
I onda ne čuješ od njega nikako.
Next time you heard from the friend, hello.
I onda sljedeći put kad te zove,
my car is broken down.
Your what?
My car is broken
Kaže,
down.
Kaže, moj auto je pokvarilo.
Can you help me?
Možeš li mi pomoć?
Will you consider that a friend?
Da li vi smatrate tu osobu
prijatelj? Is that the way you treat God?
I da li tako se odnosimo
prema
Bogu?
Do you come
Bogu?
To him only when you have need?
Da li mu dolazimo samo
Or
kad trebamo
you have
nešto?
A relationship with him?
Ili imate odnos s njim?
From faith.
Od vjere.
To faithfulness.
Do vjernosti.
The Bible says that God protects the faithful.
Biblija kaže da Bog štiti vjerne.
When you are faithful to God,
kada si vjeran Bogu,
God will protect you.
Bog će te zaštititi.
You can find that in the book of Psalms 31 verse 23. You can write it down. I'm going to move a little bit on because of time.
U Psalmu 31, 23 to možete naći. Idemo dalje radi vremena.
God
to možete sami.
God protects the faithful.
Bog štiti vjerne.
When you are faithful to God,
kada si ti Bogu vjeran,
you don't have to worry.
Ne moraš se brinuti.
God will protect you.
Bog će te štititi.
Hallelujah. You don't have to worry.
Ne morate se brinuti.
About anything.
U vezi ničega.
The Bible says no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper.
Biblija kaže da oružje protiv tebe skovano neće uspjeti.
Are faithful to God.
Ali to je za one koji su Bogu vjerni.
God wants us to be faithful.
Bog želi da budemo vjerni.
As I'm speaking to you this morning.
I kao što vam ovo jutro govorim.
I want you to think of a way that you will demonstrate your faithfulness to God.
Želim da razmišljate o načinima na koji ćete vi demonstrirati svoju vjernost Bogu.
You must find a way that you can say to God, I am faithful in this.
Morate naći način unutar sebe, Bože, ja želim biti vjeran u ovome.
I am faithful to come into church.
Ja sam vjeran u tome da dolazim u crkvu.
Every Wednesday.
Svaku srijedu.
And every Sunday.
I svaku nedjelju.
I'm faithful.
Ja sam vjeran.
Can the pastor rely on you?
Da li se pastor može osloniti
that
na tebe?
That he comes to church on Wednesday.
Da ćete doći srijedom.
He is absolutely sure if no other person comes.
Da je siguran da niko se ne
whether
pojavi.
Whether it is winter.
Da li je zima.
Whether it is summer.
Da li je ljeto.
Whether it is spring.
Da li je proljeće.
Whether it is raining.
Da li je kiša.
That when he opens this door.
Da kada on otvori ova vrata.
I will see this brother here.
Da će vidjeti tog
brata.
I will
see this sister here.
Da će vidjeti tu sestru.
Can the pastor say that concerning
da li može pastor to reći za tebe?
That you are a faithful believer.
Da si ti vjeran
vjernik. A faithful member of this church.
Vjeran član ove crkve.
Each of us.
Svatko od nas
must find a way to be faithful.
Mora naći način na koji će on biti vjeran. Da li si vjeran u svojoj desetini?
I know that when I talk about money in the church, people keep so quiet.
Znam da kad god pričam u vezi novca u crkvi, odjednom tišina.
And because of the abuse of money in the church, folks don't talk about money anymore in the church.
I zbog toga što se toliko zloupotrebljavao novac i priča i propovjedi, sad se više ni ne priča o tome.
Because of the extremity of prosperity teaching, we don't talk about money again in the church.
Zbog učenja, ekstremnog učenja o prosperitetu, sad se o novcu ni ne govori.
Are you faithful in your tithes?
Ali da li smo vjerni u desetinu?
You see, when you understand the power of money,
vidite, kada razumijete
when
silu i snagu novca,
what money is,
kada razumijete što je vaš novac,
your life will completely change.
Vaš život će se skroz promijeniti.
When it comes to worshiping God.
Kada dođe do toga da slavimo Boga.
Money is not a piece of paper.
Novac nije samo list papira.
Let me say that again.
Još jednom.
Money is not a piece of paper.
Novac nije samo papir.
I've seen over the years.
Kroz ove godine mogao sam vidjeti.
Traveling through the nations.
Dok sam putovao kroz razne države.
I've seen mad people. People are crazy.
Vidio sam ljude koji su poludili.
Who are walking stark naked.
Koji hodaju goli.
Really mad.
Skroz poludili u glave.
But there's something that you will notice.
Ali primijetit ćete nešto.
If you give a madman 20 kunas.
Ako tom luđaku, da ga tako nazovemo, date 20 kuna, on će poderati.
He can pursue everybody.
Sorry.
He can pursue people, he can become violent.
On će biti nasilan, trčati za ljudima.
But once you produce money in front of a mad person.
Ali ako mu date 20
kuna. No matter how violent the mad person is.
Bez obzira koliko je nasilna ta osoba.
He will come for the money.
On će doći za taj novac.
And when he takes that money.
I kada uzme taj novac.
He will not say I'm mad.
He will neće reći ja sam luđak.
He will never tear it.
Neće ga poderati.
He will keep it safe.
On će to
even without wearing clothes.
Čak i ako nema odjeću na sebi.
He's walking naked.
On je gol.
But he knows what money is.
Ali zna što je novac.
I have tried it.
Ja sam to pokušao.
That's why I'm saying to you.
Zato vam to govorim.
The man is mad.
Čovjek je lud, nije
he's
dobar.
Walking naked.
I hoda gol okolo.
People are scared.
Ljudi se boje njega.
I produce money.
Ja sam mu dao novac.
He looks at me.
A on zna šta to znači.
He comes for the money.
I on priđe.
He takes the money.
Uzme pare.
And I thought he's going to tear the money because
I ja sam mislio on će to poderati.
He never tore the money.
Nikad to nije to učinio.
And I went back home.
I ja sam otišao kući.
And I began to ask God.
I onda sam počeo moliti se.
What is money?
Šta je novac?
That even this man that is mad.
Da čak i ovaj
he
luđak.
He tears clothes.
Koji razire odjeću, koji hoda gol.
But when he sees money,
al kad vidi tu novčanicu,
He doesn't tear it.
On nju ne podere.
He respects it.
On je poštuje.
He takes it and keeps it safe.
On je uzme I sakrije.
Then I realize.
I onda sam shvatio.
That money.
Da novac.
Is not a piece of paper.
Nije samo papir.
Money.
Novac.
Is a piece of your life.
Je dio tvog života.
It's not a piece of paper.
Nije samo papir, nego je tvoj život.
Because.
Zašto?
You have to expense your life.
Zato što.
To be able to get money.
Morate potrošiti svoj život da bi dobili novac.
When you go to work.
Kada idete na posao.
They don't practically pay you for what you're doing.
Ne plaćaju vam to što vi činite tamo.
They pay you for the time of your life that you spent in that office.
Oni vam plaćaju vrijeme vašeg života koje ste vi proveli u tom uredu.
To work, they complain.
Zato kad dođete kasno, oni se bune.
Because it's not about what you're doing.
Jer nije u vezi toga što
it's
radite.
It's about the time of your life.
Nego u vezi vremena tvojeg života koje vi potrošite na tom mjestu.
So the company says when you come and spend 8 hours of your life.
Tako da kad vi dođete I potrošite 8 sati
in this place.
U ovome mjestu
we will calculate those hours of your life.
Mi ćemo računati, sračunati
and we say that it is worth 10,000 kunas.
Te sate I reći da to vrijedi 10,000 kuna I mi ćemo ti dati.
At the end of the month.
Na kraju mjeseca.
Not for the job that you've done,
ne na račun posla koji si napravio.
Of your life you've expended in that place.
Nego na račun sati koje si proveo na tom mjestu.
That's why you clock into the office.
Zato znači onaj kliknete kad dođete u ured i ponovo karticu
break,
kad izlazite. Kada idete na pauzu,
and you spend more than extra 5 minutes,
ako potrošite više od 5 minuta,
they query you, what happened? You're supposed to be back.
Dođu i kažu, što je bilo? Gdje si ovih 5 minuta?
Even when you have finished your job that day,
čak I ako si završio svoj posao,
you cannot say, I'm done with today, I gotta leave.
I kažete, ja sam za danas završio, ja idem. Ne.
Because your life is a composition of times, minutes and hours.
Zato što tvoj život se sastoji od sati, minuta,
sekundi. So when you lift up money before God.
Tako da kad vi podignete novac pred Boga.
You're lifting up a piece of your life.
Vi dižete komad svog života.
Because you have to expense your life to be able to get it.
Jer morate potrošiti svoj život da bi ga dobili.
Because while you're in the office day.
Jer kada ste vi u uredu.
You don't do what you like.
Ne radite možda ono što volite. Vi radite ono što od vas traže.
If you're a receptionist,
ako radite na recepciji,
your job is to smile with people that you don't even know.
Morate se smijati ljudima čak I koje ne znate.
Hello.
Dobar dan.
How are you today?
Kako ste danas?
Can I help you?
Mogu vam pomoći?
That's what they pay you for.
To je ono što vas plaćaju.
To smile with strangers.
Da se smijete
nice
strancima. Da budete fini I uljudni.
It's your life.
To je vaš život.
That you are spending there.
Da koji trošite.
So when God said bring the tithes.
Tako kad Bog kaže donesi svoje prinose.
The
vi podignete svoje prinose.
This is a piece of my life.
Ovo je dio mog života.
I am faithful.
Ja sam vjeran.
To offer it to you.
Da ti ga dam.
Are you faithful with your tithes?
Da li ste vjerni u svojim prinosima I desetinama?
When I look at the Bible.
Kada ja pogledam Bibliju.
I used to think.
Ja isto tako mislim.
That Solomon.
Da Solomon
became the richest man,
da je postao jedan najbogatiji ljudi
because of wisdom.
Zbog mudrosti.
But that is wrong.
Ali to je pogrešno.
Because the Bible says, I read the Bible says in the book of James.
Ja sam pročitao Bibliju I
is
u Jakobu
that lack
kaže,
wisdom?
Sorry.
Is there anybody that lack wisdom?
Da li ima neko kome nedostaje mudrosti?
Let him ask from God.
Neka pita od Boga.
Who gives freely?
Koji daje slobodno svima.
So if wisdom was the source of Solomon riches.
Ako je mudrost bila izvor Solomonove bogatstva.
We all should be millionaires.
Mi bi trebali svi biti milioneri.
Just ask for wisdom and money will come.
Samo tražite mudrost I novac će doći.
God gives wisdom freely.
Bog daje mudrost slobodno.
But when I look closely.
Ali kad sam malo bolje
pogledao. I find out that wisdom was not the source of Solomon wealth.
Ja sam shvatio da mudrost nije bila izvor Solomonov bogatstva. Nije bila mudrost.
It wasn't wisdom.
Nije bila mudrost.
It was offering.
Nego prinos.
It was offering.
prilici.
Second Chronicles chapter 1 verse 6 to 7.
Druga ljetopisa Second Chronicles 1
chapter 1
6 do 7.
Verse 6 to 7. The Bible says,
Biblija kaže,
all the congregation,
cijela zajednica,
came to worship God,
je došla da slavi
and
Boga,
made an offering,
i dali su prinos,
unto God,
Bogu.
But Solomon,
ali Solomon,
came,
je došao,
he offered 1,000 burnt offerings,
on je kaže, ondje, se Salomon pred Jahvom pope na tučani žrtveni koji bješe tik do šatora sastanka i prenese na njemu 1000 paljenica.
He offered 1,000 burnt offerings.
On je prinio 1000 paljenica.
Even if they were lambs.
Čak i ako je bilo janjad.
A burnt offering you have to put it on the altar, set it on fire, it burnt to ashes.
Morao si je staviti na oltar, zaklad spalit u potpunosti.
To burn 1,000 lambs, it takes a lot of time.
Da bi spalio 1000, prinio 1000 janjadi kao paljenicu, žrtvu, to treba vrijeme.
Some people offer chicken just
tako
like
da su ljudi prinosili kokoši.
One chicken is burnt in time and they go home.
A to brzo ide.
Other people came and burnt one lamb. They say,
drugi su došli i prinijeli spaljenicu, žrtvu, janje i to treba vrijeme i trud. Ali Biblija kaže da je Salomon došao i prinio 1000 paljenica. I onda Biblija kaže da te noći toliko je bilo drugačija noć. Tako i to što je Salomon napravio bilo toliko drugačije da Bog nije poslao ni anđela Mihaela ni Gabriela.
I think God said, bring out my limuzina, I need to go to Solomon.
Možda je Bog rekao, ajde donesi, dovedi mi ovu limuzinu, moram ići vidjeti Salomona.
And then Gabriel said, no, don't worry, I'll take care of that.
I možda je Gabriel rekao, ma vidi, ja ću to Bože riješiti.
I'll go.
Ja ću, po time, pošalji, ja ću ići.
You know, I'm always at your service, my Lord.
Mihael je došao i rekao, Bože, ja sam te uvijek na usluzi.
God said no.
Ali Bog rekao ne.
This one,
ovaj,
I have to go by myself.
Ja moram njega osobno
vidjeti. The Bible said that night,
i Biblija kaže,
God
iste noći,
by himself.
Bog se ukazao
Solomonu. He did not send angel.
Nije poslao anđele.
And he said to Solomon, ask me what you want.
I rekao mu, traži šta da ti dam.
So the source of Solomon's wealth,
tako da izvor Salomonovog bogatstva nije bila mudrost.
It was the offering that provoked God to come.
Nego taj prinos koji je isprovocirao Boga da dođe. Jer je onda Bog došao i rekao, traži.
And the young man said, it's only wisdom that I need.
I onda je Salomon rekao, pa trebam samo mudrost.
And God said, because of what you have done,
i onda je Bog rekao, zbog
I'm
toga što si učinio, neću ti dati samo mudrost, daću ti bogatstvo.
So the source of his wealth,
tako da izvor njegovog bogatstva
not wisdom,
nije bila mudrost,
it was the offering,
nego taj prinos
that made God to come,
koji je učinio Boga da dođe.
What are you faithful in?
U čemu si ti vjeran danas?
You have to move from just having faith.
Moraš se pomaknuti od toga da imaš samo vjeru do toga da si vjeran.
Praise the Lord.
Slava Bogu.
Because when God shows himself to those who are faithful.
Ne, jer kad se Bog ukaže onima koji su vjerni.
God gives everybody things.
Bog daje stvari svima.
But when you are faithful,
al kad si vjeran,
God manifests himself to you.
On se ukazuje tebi.
Because faithfulness is about relationship.
Jer je vjernost
God
u vezi
shows
odnosa.
To you.
Bog ti se pokaže.
When Solomon demonstrated faithfulness,
kada je Salomon pokazao
go
vjernost.
Go make your research in the Bible. Every time Solomon offers, it was unique.
I Biblija kaže da to što je Salomon napravio je bilo drugačije, unikatno. I to nije bilo samo ovaj put da je to Salomon napravio. On je bio vjeran.
Are you faithful with one tenth of that which God has blessed you?
Da li si ti vjeran u ono jednoj stvari u kojoj te Bog blagoslovio?
I know that you're quiet there. It's okay.
Vidim da ste malo tihi, okay.
When you talk about these things, people get quiet in the church.
Kada govori, kad su ovo teme u crkvi, onda se
I don't expect
utišaju.
A big amen when it comes to this.
Ne očekujem veliki amen.
I'm used to people being silent when you talk about money in the church.
Ja sam navikao da su ljudi tihi kad se govori o novcu u crkvi.
What are you faithful in?
Ali pitanje ostaje, u čemu si ti vjeran?
What can God count on you for?
U čemu Bog može na tebe računati?
Faithfulness.
Vjernost.
Is a source of promotion in life.
To je izvor promocije u životu.
If you look at the book of Matthew chapter 25 verse 21.
Ako pogledate Matej 25:21.
When you are faithful.
Kada si vjeran.
It brings promotion in life.
To ti dovede da budeš promoviran. Napreduješ. Čak i u svijetu.
A faithful staff of a company.
Vjerna, znači vjerni radnici u nekoj firmi će napredovati u toj firmi.
No matter how skilled you are.
Bez obzira koliko si ti
vješt.
Bez obzira koliko talentiran onom što radiš.
You,
ako ta firma ne može se osloniti na tebe.
Faithful,
ako nisi vjeran.
You will not be promoted.
Nećeš napredovati.
They know that you're good.
Oni znaju da si dobar.
Or when they look for you.
Ali kad te moraju tražiti.
They don't find you.
Tebe nema.
They say, no, if he's here, he will solve all the problem, but he's not here.
On će riješiti sve stvari, ali nema ga.
They will rather depend on somebody when they look for that person, they will find that person.
Sorry?
They will rather depend on somebody when they look for him, they will find that person.
Oni žele da neko koga traže, da je tu ako im treba.
So faithfulness.
Znači vjernost
is a source of promotion in life.
Je izvor napredovanja u životu.
Can we just read the book of that Matthew chapter 25 verse 21?
Matej 25:21.
Yes, 25:21.
Tada mu reče gospodar, dobro, valjani i vjerni slugo, bio si vjeran nad malim, zato ću te nad velikim postaviti. Uđi u veselje gospodara svoga.
His Lord said unto him, well done, thou good and faithful servant, thou hast been faithful over few things, I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of the Lord. If you're not faithful in little things.
Ako nisi vjeran u malim stvarima.
How can God commit to you greater things?
Kako ti Bog može predati velike stvari?
Sometimes people, you know, just tell me, pastor.
Nekad mi ljudi dođu i kažu, pastore.
Pray for me.
Moli se za me.
When I get this contract.
Da dobijem ovaj ugovor.
The profit is about 200,000 kunas.
Profit je 200,000 kuna.
I will pay my tithe.
Ja ću onda da desetinu.
I know he's lying.
I znam da laže.
If he didn't pay the tithe of 100 kuna.
Ako on nije platio desetinu od 100 kuna.
He's not going to pay the one of 200,000.
Sigurno neće od 200,000.
I know it. Over the years I've seen it.
To sam vidio kroz sve ove godine.
Pastor, just pray for me.
Pastore, moli se za mene.
When this job comes.
Kada dođe ovaj posao.
I promise you.
Ja ti obećam.
I already calculated my tithe.
Ja sam već izračunao svoje.
It's gonna be like 20,000 kunas.
20,000 kuna.
And when I check the book.
I kada ja odem.
He has not even paid the tithe of 10 kunas.
Ja kad odem vamo da vidim računovodstvo.
I know he's not gonna pay.
Ni 10 kuna
because
nije platio.
Because you're not faithful in little things.
Ako ti nisi vjeran u malome.
You cannot be faithful in much.
Ne možeš biti u velikome.
From faith to faithfulness.
Od vjere do vjernosti.
God is looking for those who will stand firm.
Bog traži one koji će stajati
the
čvrsto.
The church in Croatia is looking for those who are firm.
Crkva u Hrvatskoj traži one koji
this
će stajati čvrsto.
Is looking for those who are firm.
Ova crkva traži one koji
who
će stajati čvrsto. Koji će stajati uz pastora.
Who the pastor can rely on.
Neko na koga se pastor može osloniti.
That no matter what happens.
Da bez obzira šta da se dogodi.
I know that this brother got my back.
Ja znam da ovaj će
no matter what happens.
Bez obzira šta
I know
se dogodi.
That this family will be here.
Znam da će ovaj uvijek doći.
Everybody can leave.
Svi će otići. Svi mogu otići.
But I know that this family will never leave.
Ali znam da ovaj neće.
Jesus was looking for faithful people.
Isus je tražio vjerne ljude.
The Bible says at one point in time.
Biblija kaže u jednom trenutku.
Jesus church was about 5000 men.
Crkva Isusova je bila oko 5000 ljudi.
If all of those men only had one wife.
da su svi ti ljudi samo imali jednu ženu.
That would have been about 10,000 membership.
To je otprilike 10,000 članova u crkvi.
If they all did family planning, I had three children.
Čak i sa planiranjem obitelji da su imali dvoje, troje djece.
You will know what the size of the church.
Zamislite veličinu te
crkve. But the Bible says all of them left.
Ali Biblija kaže svi su.
And Jesus turned and looked at the disciples.
I onda je Isus pogledao svoje učenike.
Are you guys also leaving?
I rekao, hoćete li vi otići?
And Peter said, where can we go?
I onda je Petar rekao, gdje da idemo? Gdje da idemo kad si?
God is looking for faithful people.
Gdje da idemo kad si ti?
This church made faithful men and women.
Bog traži vjerne muškarce i
žene
koji će doći i slušati riječ pastorovu i biti poslušni.
Faithfulness.
Vjernost.
God reward faithfulness.
Bog nagrađuje vjernost.
Faithfulness.
Vjernost.
Is a source of righteousness.
To isto tako izvor pravednosti.
You know the Bible says none of us is righteous.
Biblija kaže nitko od nas nije pravedan.
That our righteousness is as filthy rags.
Kaže naša pravednost je ko prljave one krpe.
But when you are faithful,
al kad si ti vjeran,
it is counted to you for righteousness.
To ti se računa za pravednost.
You may not be righteous,
možda nisi pravedan,
but you can be faithful.
Al možeš biti vjeran.
Abraham was faithful.
Abraham je bio vjeran.
Faithfulness means obeying instruction.
Vjernost znači biti poslušan uputama.
God said to Abraham,
I Bog je rekao Abrahamu,
I want you to leave your country,
želim da napustiš svoju ovu
leave
zemlju,
your family,
svoju obitelj,
leave your community,
i svoju zajednicu.
I will show you,
ja ću ti pokazati
where you are going,
gdje ideš.
So Abraham took his suitcase,
i onda Abraham uzeo svoj kofer,
and said, Daddy, I'm leaving.
I rekao, tata, ja ti idem sada.
And the daddy said, where are you going?
I otac ga pita, a di ćeš?
So I don't know.
On kaže, ne znam.
God told me.
Bog mi je rekao.
I should go.
Da trebam ići.
They said, please, Abraham, you know, be serious with us.
I onda mu je tata rekao, daj, Abraham, urazum se.
How can you say you're leaving?
Kako možeš reći da ideš?
Where are you going?
Di ideš?
Abraham said, I don't know.
I Abraham opet kaže, ne znam.
God said, I should leave.
Bog mi je rekao da idem.
And his friends come to him.
Onda mu prijatelji dođu.
Abraham, we heard that you're traveling.
I rekli, Abraham, čujemo da putuješ.
Abraham say, yes, I'm traveling.
Abraham kaže, da, idem na put.
So where are you going?
A di ideš?
You know, I know you may not want to tell your parents.
Znam da ne želiš reći svojim roditeljima, ali možeš nama reći. Aj nam reci di ideš.
Confide in us.
Ajde, ima povjerenja u
where
nas.
Where are you going?
Di ideš?
Abraham say, I don't know.
Abraham kaže, nemam pojma.
Be serious with us.
Ma daj, Abraham, urazumi se.
You bag your bag?
Kako možeš se spakirati? Uze ženu.
And you say you're going.
I ić.
Where?
Di?
We will not tell your parents.
Nećemo reći, obećamo tvojim roditeljima.
Trust me, I won't tell.
Vjeruj mi, nećemo.
Abraham said, I don't know.
Abraham kaže, nemam pojma.
Faithfulness.
Vjernost.
When you're faithful to God.
Kad si ti vjeran Bogu,
you can do what no other person can do.
Možeš raditi stvari koje neko
when
drugi ne može.
God,
kad si ti vjeran Bogu,
you can obey God.
Možeš biti poslušan
That's
Bogu.
Why the Bible says Abraham become a friend of God.
Zato kaže Biblija da je Abraham postao prijatelj Boži.
God wants us to move from just having faith.
Bog želi da se pomaknemo s mjesta da imamo samo vjeru, da postanemo
in
vjerni.
The book of Daniel, chapter number 6,
u Danielu 6.
I love this story here.
I znamo ovu priču ovdje.
It's a demonstration of faithfulness.
Ovo je demonstracija vjernosti.
Daniel chapter 6.
Daniel 6.
Look at verse 1.
1.
Well, let me move a little bit farther to verses 4.
Pročitat ćemo 4.
Then the presidents and the princes sought to find occasion against Daniel concerning the kingdom. But they could not find none occasion nor fault, for as much as he was faithful, neither was any error or fault found in him.
6:4.
Yes, Daniel 6.
Daniel se toliko isticaše svojim izvanrednim duhom iznad pročelnika i satrapa, te kralj mišljaše da ga postavi nad svim kraljevstvom. Tada pročelnici i satrapi stadoše tražiti povod, što god oko državne uprave, zbog čega bi mogli optužiti Daniela, ali ne mogoše na njemu naći ništa takvo, ništa zbog čega bi ga prekorili, jer bijaše vjeran, na njemu ni ne nemara ni ogrešenja.
They did not find any fault in him.
Nisu mogli naći ni jednu grešku.
Not because he did not have faults.
Ne zato što on nije imao
but
greške.
Because he was faithful.
Nego zato što je bio vjeran.
And so the Bible says his colleagues.
I Biblija kaže da ovi satrapi, pročelnici tražili su grešku.
They did not like him.
Nije im se sviđao
Daniel. They tried to set him up.
Pokušali su mu namjestiti povod.
And when they could not find a way to set him up,
ali nisu mogli naći način kako da mu postave stupicu. I onda su došli kralju.
And said to the king, you have to pass a decree.
Onda su rekli, vidi, ti moraš napraviti
in this kingdom,
jedan zakon da
no
u ovom kraljevstvu
pray to any other god except you.
Da se niko ne smije nikome, nijednom Bogu moliti osim
and
tebe.
And whosoever prays to another god,
i ako se neko bude molio nekom drugom Bogu,
will be thrown into the lion's den.
Neka se baci u lavlju jazbinu.
They knew that Daniel was faithful in his prayers.
Oni su znali da je Daniel bio vjeran i u molitvama.
That no matter what happened,
da bez obzira šta da se dogodi,
Daniel would pray.
Daniel će se moliti.
He has a specific time of prayer.
Imao je točno vrijeme molitve.
And he would pray to the God of heaven.
I molio se nebeskom
Otcu.
So
they went to the king.
I oni su došli kralju.
And they say, king, pass a decree.
I rekli kralju, ti donesi ovaj
in
zakon.
This kingdom,
da ni jedna osoba
can pray to any other god,
u ovom kraljestvu ne smije se moliti jednom
you.
Drugom Bogu osim tebi.
And the king innocently signed that decree.
I nevino kralj potpiše to.
And the Bible said by the decree of the law of the Medes and the Persians it will never change.
I Biblija kaže da taj zakon, po tom zakonu nije se, bio je nepromjenjiv. Kaže da bude neopoziv prema nepromjenjivom medijsko-perzijskom zakonu.
And Daniel did not know what was going on.
Neopoziv zakon. A Daniel nije imao pojma šta se događa, a bio je vjeran.
He was faithful.
Bio je vjeran.
And after the king assigned the decree,
i kada je kralj potpisao taj zakon,
they went and spied on Daniel.
Oni su otišli i špionirali Daniela i gledali na svom mobitelu.
And they wait, they know that Daniel will go to pray in that particular time.
I znali su oni da će Daniel kada dođe to vrijeme molitve molit se.
And they take a video clip.
I onda su uzeli svoj mobitel i krenuli snimati.
And they went back to the president.
I onda su došli tamo tom pročelniku.
And said, president, how are you today?
I rekli, pročelniče, kako se osjećaš danas?
Everything is going on well.
Oh, dobro.
And they said, president, did you remember the decree that you signed last week?
I onda došli i rekli tom kralju, sjećaš se onog zakona što si neki dan potpisao?
And he said, yeah, I remember.
Da, sjećam se.
Well, there's some people in this kingdom.
I kaže, znaš, u ovom kraljestvu ima neki ljudi.
They don't respect you.
Koji te ne poštuju.
They don't respect anything you say.
Ne poštuju ništa što ti govoriš.
And one of them,
i jedan od tih,
is the man that you like,
je onaj koga ti voliš,
is Daniel.
To je Daniel.
And the king said, no, Daniel is a faithful.
On kaže, ne, Daniel je vjeran
čovjek.
He's
a good guy.
On je dobar.
They said, watch this clip.
Pogledaj sada ovaj video.
Did you not say nobody should pray to any other god?
Zar ti nisi rekao da ne smije niko se moliti nekom drugom Bogu? I kada Biblija kaže,
when the king watched the clip,
da kada je
he saw Daniel praying to the God of heaven.
Kada je kralj pogledao taj klip,
when he's supposed to be praying to him,
i vidio da se Daniel moli Bogu nebeskom, a ne njemu.
The Bible says the king tried everything.
Biblija kaže da je kralj pokušao sve
to save Daniel from these conspirators.
Da spasi Daniela od te kazne. Urote.
But they couldn't.
Ali nije mogao.
They said to the king,
i onda su oni rekli
kralju, you remember the law of our land?
Sjećaš se zakona naše zemlje?
Once you sign it,
jednom kad ti to potpišeš, Ne može biti to opozvano.
Daniel has to be thrown into the lion's den.
Daniel mora biti bačen lavovima.
The Bible says,
Biblija kaže,
the king was so troubled,
da je kralj bio toliko uznemiren,
that throughout the night,
da kroz cijelu tu noć,
he couldn't sleep.
Nije oka sklopio.
But God,
ali Bog,
protects,
štiti,
the faithful,
vjerne.
And so while they were preparing,
i dok su se oni spremali,
while the conspirators were rejoicing,
dok su ti urotnici se zabavljali i slavili,
we finally got him.
Napokon smo ga uhvatili.
Daniel.
Daniela.
He will know.
On će saznati.
That we have been here before him.
Da smo ovdje mi prije njega.
The lions are going to finish him.
Lavovi će ga rastrgat.
And that will be his end.
I to će biti njegov kralj. Kraj.
Thank goodness.
Hvala Bogu.
We finally get Daniel.
Napokon smo uhvatili Daniela.
What did he not know?
Ali nisu znali.
That when you are faithful to God.
Kada si ti vjeran Bogu.
God protects you.
Bog te štiti.
So before they could put Daniel in the lion's den.
Tako da prije nego što su mogli pustiti Daniela
God went forth.
U lavlju jamu. Bog je otišao lavovima.
And say, hey lions, how are you today?
I rekao, hey lavovi, kako vam je danas? Kako
lions
ste?
Whoa, we are fine. We are ready.
Mi smo spremni.
And God said to the lions.
I Bog je rekao lavovima.
Have you ever tried some vegetarian food?
Da li ste ikad možda probali vegetarijansku ishranu?
Lion said, no.
Ne, kako?
So you if you never tried.
Ako niste probali.
You need to try it.
Možda bi trebali.
The doctor says it's good for the
doktori
body.
Kažu da je odlično.
All these vegetables.
Svi ovo povrće, voće odlično.
So why don't you guys keep the meat for about 2 days?
Zašto možda jedno dva dana ne preskočite koje jelo?
Say, wow, what a good idea.
Kažu lavovi. Dobra ideja.
We've been eating meat all along.
Sorry?
We've been eating meat all our life.
Kaže, jedemo ovo meso cijeli
what
život.
What a great opportunity to be a vegetarian.
Nevjerojatna prilika da budemo vegetarijanci.
And God settled with the lions.
I Bog je riješio stvar s lavovima.
But the conspirators.
Ali ti urotnici.
We're getting ready.
Ali su se spremali.
And so they opened the lion's den.
Otvorili su lavlju jamu.
And they dropped Daniel.
I spustili lava
and
ovoga Daniela.
And the lion said, "Daniel, welcome."
I lavovi su došli, Daniel
just
rekli,
came at the right time.
Dobro došao,
we
došao.
Are practicing vegetarians.
Došao si u pravo vrijeme, jer mi upravo smo postali
vegetarijanci.
Ne jedemo meso dva dana.
We are practicing vegetarians.
Mi smo trenutno vegetarijanci.
The doctor says good for our body.
Bog kaže da je to dobro za
so
naše
welcome,
tijelo.
Daniel, sit.
I tako izvoli sjesti.
And while they were waiting,
i dok su oni čekali,
for the lions to devour.
Za lavove da požeru.
Because Daniel was faithful.
Zato jer je Daniel bio vjeran.
When you are faithful.
Kada si ti vjeran.
God shows himself to you.
Bog ti se pokaže.
When you are faithful.
Kada si vjeran.
God manifests his power in your life.
Bog pokazuje svoju silu i snagu.
When you are faithful.
Kada si vjeran.
The situation that destroys other people cannot destroy you.
Situacija koja uništava druge
when
ljude ne može tebe.
To God,
kad si vjeran
what
Bogu.
Happens to other people,
ono što se događa drugima.
That get them into depression.
Koje ih je gurnulo u depresiju.
When it happens to you.
Kad se tebi dogodi.
It becomes a source of thanksgiving.
To postaje izvor zahvale u tvom životu.
Faithfulness.
Vjernost.
Faithfulness.
Vjernost.
God wants us to move from just having faith.
Bog želi da se mičemo od točke samo imanja vjere do mjesta gdje ćemo biti vjerni.
Faithful to God.
Vjerni Bogu.
When nobody is there.
Kada nitko nije tu.
You're faithful to God.
Ti si vjeran.
Faithful in your prayer.
Vjeran svojim molitvama.
Faithful in your Bible study.
Vjeran u svom proučavanju Biblije.
You may tell me I don't understand the Bible.
Možete reći, ja ne razumijem
but
Bibliju.
If you have a time,
ali ako imate vrijeme
that you will set apart,
koje ćete odvojiti
to just take the Bible and read,
da uzmete i da čitate
even
Bibliju.
If it's for 10 minutes,
čak i ako je 10
and
minuta.
You're faithful to it,
i ako ste vjerni
before
to
you know,
vrlo uskoro
understanding will come to you.
Razumijevanje će vam doći.
God wants us to be faithful.
Bog želi da budemo
the
vjerni.
Question is, what are you faithful in?
Pitanje jeste, u čemu si ti
what
vjeran?
Can heaven recognize you for?
U čemu te nebo danas može prepoznati?
Can heaven recognize you as a faithful tither?
Da li te nebo danas može prepoznat kao vjernog
darivalca?
Kao vjernog člana crkve koji dolazi vjerno?
Can heaven recognize you for anything?
Da li te nebo ovo jutro može prepoznat
ičemu?
Ovaj ovdje je vjeran u ovome.
I'm not even talking about man. I'm not even talking about a man.
Ne govorim u vezi čovjeka samo.
I'm talking about the God that sees in secret.
Govorim o Bogu koji prepoznaje.
Can he recognize you and see you as a faithful
person? Onaj Bog koji vidi u tajnosti, da li on te može prepoznat u nečemu?
God delivers Daniel.
Bog oslobađa Daniela.
Because Daniel was faithful.
Zato što je Daniel bio vjeran.
Daniel was faithful to God.
Daniel je bio vjeran Bogu.
No matter what the enemy will do.
Bez obzira što će neprijatelj napraviti. Bog će uvijek zaštititi.
Those who are faithful to him.
One koji su mu vjerni.
And the Bible says he is a rewarder.
I Bog kaže da Biblija kaže da je Bog onaj koji nagrađuje vjerne. Sad vrijeme mi ne dozvoljava.
Let me talk to you about the three Hebrew children.
Da vam govorim o trojici hebrejskih dječaka.
Šadrak,
Mešak i Abednego.
They are epitome of faithfulness.
Oni su primjer vjernosti.
In the book of Daniel chapter number 3.
I u Danielu 3.
The Bible says Nebukadnezar.
Biblija kaže da Nabukodonozor
set up a golden image.
Je postavio jedan zlatni kip.
And passed a decree.
I proglasio zakon.
And say everybody.
I rekao da svatko,
at the sound of the music, the trumpet,
kada truba zatrubi,
everybody in Babylon,
svako ko je u Babilonu,
must bow and worship that golden image.
Mora se pokloniti i slaviti ta tog kipa.
When you are faithful,
kada si ti vjeran,
you cannot compromise the truth.
Ne možeš napravi kompromis
no
sa
matter
istinom.
What, you will not be able to compromise.
Bez obzira na bilo što.
So the Bible says,
tako Biblija kaže,
these three Hebrew children,
ova tri dječaka,
they said,
oni su rekli,
we will not bow.
Mi nećemo se pokloniti.
No matter what,
bez obzira
we serve
na bilo
the God
što,
of heaven,
mi služimo nebeskom Bogu.
And they were accosted and bring to King Nebuchadnezzar.
I njih su uhvatili i doveli Nabukodonozoru.
So here is Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego.
I evo Shadrach, Meshach i Abednego stoje pred kraljem.
In front of the king Nebuchadnezzar.
Stoje pred Nabukodonozorom.
The greatest kingdom of the ancient world.
Najveće kraljevstvo toga vremena.
And Nebuchadnezzar look at these young folks.
I Nabukodonozor pogleda u trojicu
and he smiled at them.
I nasmije im se.
He said, I think that you don't understand what this is all
kaže,
about.
Mislim, možda niste dobro razumjeli o čemu se
odradi. I know that you people are not from here.
Znam da vi niste odavde.
So maybe you did not understand what
I možda vi niste razumjeli cijeli ovaj zakon,
that
znate.
Any time you hear the sound of that
da kad
god
čujete trubu,
you ought to bow there and worship
vi trebate se pokloniti.
That I, Nebuchadnezzar, set it
da
up.
Ja, ovaj Nabukodonozor, sam postavio
so
taj
kip. Because you guys are foreigners here.
I znam da ste vi stranci.
Let's assume that the announcement came in the local language you did not really understand.
Ali možda da je došlo u lokalnom jeziku, možda bi razumjeli, ali pošto
so
nije,
I'm
možda niste.
Give you a second chance.
Ali evo daću vam drugu šansu.
Yeah. I'm going to give you a second chance.
Da, odlučio sam, daću vam drugu šansu.
So, you guys will go back.
Sad ćete lijepo otići nazad.
You know how the president talks.
Znate kako predsjednik to.
He's not sure, he's not angry, he's just giving them benefit of doubt.
On nije ljut, ali daje im jednostavno drugu šansu.
And he said, I'm going to give you guys a second chance.
Daću vam priliku da ispravite ovo.
Just go back.
Ajde lijepo se sad vratite.
It's very, very simple.
Vrlo je ovo jednostavna uputa.
When you hear the sound of the music,
kada truba zatrubi, vi se poklonite i proslavite taj kip. I više nikad nećete imati problema sa mnom. A ja znam da vi ne želite imati problema sa mnom. I on je bio uljudan, fin. Ovoj trojici hebrejskih dječaka.
But what Nebuchadnezzar expected,
ali ono što je Nabukodonozor možda očekivao,
He got a big surprise.
I on se jako iznenadio.
Because he thought that the three Hebrew children would say thank you, thank you, thank you.
On je mislio će njih trojica reći hvala ti, hvala ti, hvala vam.
For giving us another opportunity, we are sorry.
Hvala vam za drugu
we
šansu.
Will bow down.
Oprostite, oprostite,
oprostite. Sorry, please.
Oprostite, oprostite, sad ćemo mi to ispraviti.
But he got a surprise.
Ali malo se iznenadio.
And nobody
I nitko
has ever stood and confronted Nebuchadnezzar.
Nitko nije ustao I usprotivio se Nabukodonozoru.
But these three Hebrew children
Ali
looked at him
trojica
dječaka
pogledali su ga ravno u oči.
Say, King Nebuchadnezzar,
I rekli, kralju Nabukodonozoru,
thank you for your offer.
Hvala na ovom...
We don't even have to go home and think and come back.
Sorry?
We don't have to go
ne moramo ići kući nazad, razmisliti, vratiti se s odgovorom.
King Nebuchadnezzar,
kralju Nabukodonozoru,
we want you to know,
mi želimo da ti znaš
that the three of us,
da nas trojica ode,
we will never bow,
mi se nikad nećemo pokloniti
onom
ekipu.
It doesn't matter what you're going to do.
Bez obzira šta ti napravio.
And the Bible says,
I Biblija kaže,
Nebuchadnezzar was outraged.
Nabukodonozor se razbjesnio.
You could see his eyes turn red out of anger.
Kaže, crvenilo mu se u očima
pokazalo.
Niko na taj način nije prije pričao sa Nabukodonozorom. I Biblija kaže
that Nebuchadnezzar ordered,
da je Nabukodonozor naredio da onu peć užare 7 puta više. Hoću ih ispržiti. Da oni znaju ko sam ja.
And the three Hebrew children responded.
A njih trojica su odgovorili.
And they said something.
I onda su oni rekli nešto.
That is the epitome of faithfulness.
Nešto što je primjer
they said to Nebuchadnezzar,
vjernosti. Rekli su mu.
If the God that we serve,
ako I Bog kojeg mi služimo,
he can deliver us,
on nas može izbaviti
from your hand,
iz tvoje ruke.
But if he choose not to,
ali ako on I odluči ne učiniti to,
die.
Mi ćemo umrijeti.
They said, the God that we serve,
kažu, Bog kojeg mi služimo,
is so powerful,
on je toliko moćan,
he can deliver us,
on nas može izbaviti
from your hand,
iz tvoje ruke.
But just in case,
ali u slučaju,
he choose not to deliver us,
ako on odluči da nas ne izbavi,
we will not bow.
Mi se nećemo pokloniti.
That is faithfulness.
To je vjernost.
Faithfulness says something like this.
Vjernost kaže nešto poput
ovog. I'm gonna come to church.
Sorry.
I'm gonna come to church.
Ja ću doći u crkvu.
I will pay my tithes.
Ja ću platiti.
I will
ja
be
ću,
faithful.
Da ću dati svoju
if
desetinu.
God did not give me the answer to my prayer.
Čak I ako Bog ne daje odgovor
if
na moje molitve.
I am not healed,
ako nisam iscijeljen,
if I never receive that miracle,
ako nikad ne primim svoje
I will
čudo,
still worship God.
Ja ću još uvijek služiti Bogu.
That is what faithfulness is all about.
To je vjernost.
Faithfulness say, if I get it,
vjernost kaže, ako dobijem, slava Bogu.
If I did not get it,
ako ne dobijem,
praise the Lord.
Slava Bogu.
If God healed me,
ako me Bog iscijeli,
I will give him glory.
Ja ću mu dati slavu.
If he did not heal me,
ako me ne iscijeli,
I will still give him glory.
Ja ću mu još uvijek dati slavu.
I don't know who I'm talking to this morning. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning.
Ne znam kome govorim ovo jutro.
That is faithfulness.
Ali to je vjernost.
Faithfulness is not about what I can get.
Vjernost nije uvjeti toga šta ti možeš dobiti. Vjernost je slaviti Boga zato što je to Bog. Vjernost je toga da, da ga mi slavimo jer nas je On stvorio da ga slavimo. Bez obzira jesam li blagoslovljen u poslu, da li dobijem to, to napredovanje ili ne, i da li se crkva moli za mene, ako se I molitva nije ispunila, još uvijek ću ga slaviti. Još uvijek ću doći u
crkvu.
Još uvijek ću biti vjeran.
Because he is God.
Zato jer On Bog.
So the three Hebrew children,
tako da trojica dječaka
said to Nebuchadnezzar,
rekli su Nabukodonozoru,
if the God that we serve,
ako Bog kojeg mi služimo
does not deliver us,
ne izbavi nas,
we will not, you know, worry.
Mi se nećemo brinuti.
We are ready to die.
Mi smo spremni umrijeti.
And the Bible said they bind them up.
Biblija kaže da su ih svezali.
And Nebuchadnezzar said, hit that furnace 7 times.
A Nabukodonozor je naredio da se peć užari 7 puta
and
više.
And tied them up.
I svezali su ih.
And the Bible says,
i Biblija kaže,
that the people that took them into the furnace,
da ljudi koji su ih odveli u tu peć, bacili,
kill all of them.
Da je ta vatra njih ubila,
so
stražare.
Three folks.
Njih su bacili u vatru.
Into the fire. And Nebuchadnezzar was sitting there.
A Nabukodonozor je onda sjedio.
So you will fry it in the fire.
Sada ću ispržiti i spaliti. Da znaju da sam ja Nabukodonozor. Ali Biblija kaže,
when he looked,
kada je pogledao,
he saw about four people.
Vidio otprilike četvorcu.
He said, bring me my glasses.
I re, donesi mi moje naočale.
Did we not put three people inside there?
I rekao, zar mi nismo trojicu bacili?
There seemed to be another person.
Izgleda da tamo ima još
and
neko.
When he looked inside the fire,
i kada je pogledao u tu vatru,
instead of this guy is burning,
umjesto da ti, da ta trojica, da ta trojica su spržena i spaljena, on je vidio kako plešu.
And Nebuchadnezzar said, bring me my glasses.
I Nabukodonozor je tražio svoje naočale.
Are they not three people?
Zar tamo nismo bacili trojicu?
They are not burning.
Oni ne gore.
They seem to be dancing.
Izgleda da plešu.
Inside the fire.
U vatri.
They are, they... The power of faithfulness.
Sila i snaga vjernosti.
God manifests himself.
Bog se pokazuje.
To those who are faithful.
Onima koji su vjerni.
God sent me to call people today.
Bog me pozvao da poslao da pozovem ljude.
You want to be faithful to God.
Da na vjernost.
Because
da li želite biti vjerni? Jer će Bog pokazati svoju snagu u tvom životu.
When you are faithful to God.
Kada si ti vjeran Bogu.
God manifests.
Bog se pokazuje.
In the fire.
U vatri.
And the fire.
I vatra.
Could not burn them.
Ih nije mogla spaliti.
They came out of the fire.
Izišli su iz vatre.
And Nebuchadnezzar passed a decree.
I onda je Nabukodonozor donio novi zakon.
This, the kingdom must worship the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Da njegovo kraljestvo treba slaviti Boga od te trojice dječaka.
The situation in Croatia.
Ako će se situacija u Hrvatskoj promijeniti.
Economically.
Ekonomski.
Socially.
Socijalno.
Politically.
Politički.
The church.
Crkva.
Need faithful people.
Mora imati vjerne ljude.
People will be faithful in prayer.
Ljudi koji su vjerni u molitvi.
People will be sold out for Jesus.
Ljudi koji su predani Isusu.
We are not going to win them.
Sorry.
We are not going to win.
Nećemo dovesti ljude.
By nice sermons.
Tako što ćemo lijepo propovijedati.
We are going to win.
Mi ćemo dovesti ljude Kristu.
By being witnesses.
Tako što ćemo biti svjedoci.
They will see the power of God.
Vidjet će silu Božju
in our lives.
U našim životima.
Neighbors will say, I want to go to that church you are going.
Oni će doći i reći, želimo ići u crkvu koju ti ideš.
Take me to your church.
Odvedi me u tvoju crkvu.
Because they see the glory of God.
Jer će vidjeti slavu Božju u tvom životu.
This morning.
Ovo jutro.
I came to call folks.
Došao sam da pozovem ljude koji žele biti vjerni. Bog pokazuje svoju silu. Razlog zašto ne doživljavamo silu Božju
is not because God is, has changed.
Ne zato što se Bog promijenio.
It's not because of computer age.
Ne zbog kompjuterskog vremena u kojem živimo. Ne zbog tehnologije i selfona, mobitela. Nego zato, because of,
we are not faithful.
Zato što nismo vjerni
he
Bogu.
Says, seek me,
nego on kaže, traži
me
i ti ćeš me pronaći.
After you seek for me with the whole of your heart,
kad me budeš tražio svim svojim srcem,
it takes faithfulness
potrebna je vjernost
to experience God.
Da bi doživjeli Boga.
God is calling us.
Bog nas zove.
Not just to have faith,
ne samo da imamo vjeru,
but to become faithful worshipers.
Nego da budemo vjerni, oni koji
faithful?
Su vjerni. Da li si ti vjeran?
Can you say that you're faithful?
Da li možeš reći da
what
si vjeran?
Area are you faithful in?
U kojem području svog života
can
si
God
vjeran?
Rely on you?
Da li se Bog može osloniti na tebe? Šadrak, Mešak i Abednego su rekli,
if God did not deliver us,
ako nas Bog i ne izbavi, mi ćemo umrijeti.
You know,
mi znamo da je on Bog.
When you're faithful to God,
kada si ti vjeran Bogu,
you don't have alternative.
Nemaš alternativu.
If you're faithful to this assembly,
ako si ti vjeran ovoj zajednici,
you don't have alternative.
Nemaš alternativu.
It's not that if it doesn't work, I'll go to the other church.
Nije, nemaš taj stav, ako ovo ne upali,
in,
idem negdje drugo.
There are many churches in Zagreb.
Ima puno crkava u Zagrebu.
That is not faithfulness.
To nije vjernost.
Faithfulness, I'm here.
Vjernost, ja
God
sam ovdje.
Me here.
Bog me ovdje postavio.
I will be here.
Ja želim biti ovdje.
Until the glory of God is revealed.
Ja ću biti ovdje dok se Božja slava ne očituje. Ja sam vjeran.
That God has planted me here.
Ovdje zajednici u kojoj me Bog
it's not
postavio.
About anybody.
nije u vezi ničega.
It's about where God has planted me.
Nego mjesto gdje me Bog posadio.
God is a God of places.
Bog je Bog mjesta.
God is a God of places.
Bog je Bog mjesta.
You don't get blessed in every place.
Ne budeš blagoslovljen na svakom mjestu.
The Bible says Jesus could not do miracles in his hometown.
Biblija kaže da Isus nije mogao učiniti čudesa u svom rodnom gradu.
Said to Jacob, arise and go to Bethel.
Bog je rekao Jakovu, ustani idi u Betel.
Abraham, come out, I will show you another place.
Ustani i ideš na drugo mjesto, ću
so
ti pokazati.
Where God has planted you,
nego mjesto gdje te je Bog
you
posadio,
have to learn to be faithful.
Moraš naučiti biti vjeran.
Bow your heads in prayer.
Ajmo spusti glave u molitvu.
I want to call for the faithful people.
Ja želim uputiti poziv vjernim ljudima.
That's what God sent me to.
To me Bog poslao ovo jutro.